Hello everybody, I'm Julie and welcome to my channel. All right guys, today's topic is childhood infections and kidney disease. This information is coming from the National Kidney Foundation, so let's get started. Most people don't know it, but common childhood infections can cause kidney damage and kidney failure. This is especially true for children. Two childhood infections to be aware of are, number one, strep infections called by the Streptococcus bacteria, which leads to strep throat and impetigo, a skin infection. And number two, urinary tract infections. These conditions need prompt attention and must be treated with antibiotics in order to prevent long-term problems. Bacterial infections do not go away by themselves in the same way that viruses might do. It is true that antibiotics used for the wrong reason can be a problem, but with these two types of infection, it is important to use antibiotics right away. The connection between strep and the kidneys is that after your child has had either of the throat or skin strep infection, they can develop post-streptococcal glomerulus nephritis, PSGN. The strep bacteria travel to the kidneys and make the filtering units of the kidney glomeruli inflamed, causing the kidneys to be less able to filter urine. Fortunately, PSGN is less common today because of antibiotics. PSGN can develop 1 to 2 weeks after an untreated throat infection or 3 to 4 weeks after an untreated skin infection. It occurs most often in 6 to 10-year-olds. It is always best to follow up with your healthcare provider as soon as possible. Testing is quick and easy, and once your child begins antibiotics, they will start feeling better quite quickly. Urinary tract infections, UTIs, should also be followed up and treated promptly. They are most often caused by E. coli bacterium. All children can get a UTI, but they are most common in girls and in boys less than 6 months old who have not had been circumcised, which means had their foreskin covering their penis removed. Most UTIs are not serious, but some can lead to kidney scars and poor kidney function if left untreated. This is why it is important to start them on antibiotics as soon as possible. Some UTIs that occur very suddenly can be life-threatening, especially if the bacteria enters the bloodstream. If you have antibiotics in your home that were prescribed for a different problem, do not use them. Your healthcare provider must first check with the type of bacteria is causing the UTI to see which antibiotic will be effective. It is very dangerous if you use the wrong antibiotic. After your child is found to have a UTI, more tests may be needed, to make sure that the infection is not being caused by urine backing up the bladder and into the kidneys, or if there is a blockage in the urinary tract. These situations can both lead to permanent kidney damage if not taken care of right away. Okay, everyone, this is childhood infections and kidney disease. When I read this article, truthfully, I was not aware that strep throat or your UTIs can give you problems with your kidneys. And I'm not sure that a lot of parents are aware that that these two infections may lead to kidney failure or kidney disease. So as a parent, not as a young child anymore, but as for parents that have young children, if you find that your child has strep throat or UTI, I think the best thing to do, of course, is always make sure that it is taken care of properly and quickly to make sure that everything is taken care of and it does not lead to kidney failure. So guys, if you found this information useful in any way, please like, share, and subscribe. And as always, always sending you so much love and affection and letting you know that you are not traveling this journey alone by a long shot, guys. There are so many of us that have traveled this road and are still on it. You know, even though we have a transplant, we still have kidney disease. So we understand exactly what you're going through. And I want you to know that, like I said, you are not alone in this journey. There are so many people working in the background with so many organizations trying to find the best treatment for all of us that have CKD. So guys, the only thing that we have to do, of course, is stay compliant with our doctor's orders. Be hopeful always, guys. Be positive always, no matter what's going on in your life. And of course, to always take care of yourselves. Thank you guys for listening, and I will see you on the next video. Bye.